The first step in setting up your lead distribution process is defining the rules that govern all of the incoming leads, both from internal marketing activities or from third-party sources. This is done through a vendor and source hierarchy. For example, a vendor would be an affiliate network in which you have an offer, a bulk emailer or a marketing company that you outsource paid search to. If you are working with third-party sellers, you can create a login for them to view things like their lead activity, various reports, and even web campaigns, where they can build their own links to drive traffic to your landing pages like a traditional affiliate management system. The next level of organization is the source. While a vendor may have multiple sources, each source can only have one vendor for reporting purposes. Each lead that comes into your system is routed based on the source that it came from. Because of this, your source settings are the most important feature when dealing with your inbound leads. When we create a source, we can set the defining variables that tell the system what actions to take for leads coming in from this particular source. On this page, there are about 30 different switches that allow you to customize your source settings based on the incoming traffic, allowing you maximum flexibility when bringing leads into the system. Finally, the last part of tracking and segmenting leads that I would like to show you is the vendor admin page. You have the option to give vendor login accounts to anyone that is supplying you with leads. When logging in, your vendor will have access to their own dashboard, leads page, reports, and the link builder for your web campaigns. You can also customize your vendor's permissions and allow them access to only the tools and features of your choosing. Now that we've established the rules of inbound leads and where we can set them in the system, our next step is to set the business rules that define who each lead will be sold to and for how much.